Paul despised the hypocrisy of this perverted gospel. The Jews from Judea went everywhere teaching, except you be circumcised after the manner of Moses, you can't be saved. Now, they are believers. They believe in Jesus Christ, but they're saying you have to add the law. You have to add circumcision or you can't be saved. It's Jesus plus circumcision. They were mostly converted Pharisees, the Bible said, which believed. And they taught it was necessary to circumcise and to command them to keep the law. And you know what the law, he's not talking just about the moral law, he's talking about the ceremonial law of Moses. The washing of hands, you dare not eat. I'll tell you, you grieve God if you didn't wash your hands before you ate. You wash every pot, you wash every pan. Over 400 rules and regulations, and they saying, yes, you're saved by faith. But then after you're saved by faith, you have to work this out. You come back under the law, and all these do's, all these don'ts, that you may please God. And Paul preached that all believers are purified one way only, and that is by faith. That through grace, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved, but not by the works of the flesh. And Paul says, you're preaching another gospel. That is not the gospel of Christ. He said, I marvel that you're so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ to this other gospel. Then he added these words, you have perverted the gospel of Christ, Galatians 1:7. Believe me, folks, any gospel that promotes confidence in the flesh is another gospel. It's not the gospel of Jesus Christ whatsoever. Any gospel that yokes you to a burden of striving to please God is not the gospel. It's another gospel. It's a perversion of the gospel of grace. Now, Paul looked these Judaizers in the eye. In essence, this is what he's saying. He said, you claim to be born again by the Spirit of God. You call him Lord. You testify that you're clean in Christ. And still you call the Gentile dogs. He said, your legalism has robbed you of all love for hurting people. And folks, that's the problem with legalism. It is so judgmental. There's no love to it. There's no love whatsoever. And this is the problem with these people, these Judaizers who are coming from Jerusalem, trying to conform, trying to glory in the flesh of these people. And Paul said, you call my Gentile friends dogs. You won't eat with them. You won't even worship with them. And yet you're trying to come down here and conform them to your perverted gospel. He said, you're like hound dogs, is what he's saying, because the word in Hebrew is hound. He said, you hear of a new convert and you take off after him and you hound him. You're trying to bring him under subjection to all your rules and regulations, say, yes, you're safe. And I'll tell you what, if you sat and listened to these Pharisees, most of them were converted Pharisees, and if you listened to them teach, you would have heard a gospel of Jesus. You would have heard about Christ died on the cross. They would tell you about his resurrection. They would tell you about how they walk with him, about intimacy. They would tell you all of these things. They could tell you all about Christ. But then came the mixture. Then suddenly came the perversion. Yes, you're saved by faith, but once you're saved by faith, then God expects you to come in now, and you have got to get victory over your flesh. This is an incredible thing. Paul is a loving man. He's a forgiving man. In fact, he wrote to the Galatians, brethren, if a man is overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore this man in the spirit of meekness. Now, this is a loving man. He said, I can put up with any man's fault. I can put up with any man who's failed me or even the body. I can forgive a man who's repented of adultery, fornication. He said, I'll restore that man in meekness. He said, that's what we're called. That's the gospel. But he said, on this issue, no, on this issue of holding fast to justification by faith alone and not by human works and human ability, I will withstand you. I don't care if your name is Peter I don't care if it's Barnabas. I don't know who it is. I love you, but your gospel is wrong.